Good morning, children. Our today's topic is very interesting. That is LHS equals to RHS rule. Now, what is this rule? Children, while doing the equations, this rule can be utilized. And further, whenever you will do the equations, this will help you. This is called transposition. Trans means which can be changed. Position means place. Means transposition means we are changing or exchanging the position of two things. And what are those two things? In the equation, two sides are there. And what are those two sides? Suppose I am writing here 3 multiplied by 2 is equals to 6. So 3 multiplied by 2 is given at the left hand side. So this has become LHS side. And 6 is given at the right hand side. So this will become right hand side. So LHS stands for left hand side. And RHS stands for right hand side. Now children, whenever you are solving any equations, you are using this rule. How? You remember when we were doing LCM and HCF? There we were proving that multiplication of two numbers are equal to the multiplication of LCM and HCF. So we were proving that left hand side is equal to right hand side. So in the equations, we proves LHS is equals to RHS. Now where can we use this rule? Most of the time when you are solving the equations, when one quantity is unknown, to find that quantity, you use this rule. How you use this rule? See, if the number in any of the side is adding or subtracting or multiplying or dividing, when we take that number to another side, its sign changes. And how does it change? Look here. If the number is adding in left hand side, when we take that number to right hand side, this will become minus. Means that will convert into minus. Okay? If that number is subtracting in left hand side, when we take that number to right hand side, that will become positive. That will add in right hand side. The same goes to right hand side. If the number in right hand side is subtracting, when that number goes to the left hand side, this will add there. And if the number is adding in right hand side, when it goes to the left hand side, it will subtract. That just like that, if in the right hand side the number is dividing, when it goes to the left hand side, it will multiply there. And if it is multiplying, it will divide there. And the same rule goes to the right hand side. I will show you some example, then you understand this. X plus 4 is equals to 10. X is a quantity which is unknown. This we have to find out. Now how can we find it out? I will take this 4 to right hand side. This is left hand side. This is right hand side. So as 4 is adding over here, when I take this 4 to the right hand side, it will subtract. Look at that rule. So I will write x is equals to 10. Here because this is plus 4, so here it has become minus 4. So now x is 10 minus 4 is 6. So children, you understood this? Children, let's take one more example. Suppose 15 minus 2 is equals to x plus 4. Now, the quantity is unknown at right hand side. So what we will do? We will take this number to the left hand side. Okay? 15 minus 2 is 13. Now I will take this 4 to the left hand side. So this 4 will become minus 4 is equals to x. 13 minus 4 is 9. So the answer is 9. Now here you can check your answer also. How? As this unknown quantity you got 9, so I will write this number over here. So how will I write? 15 minus 2 is equals to 9 plus 4. Okay? 15 minus 2 is 13. 9 plus 4 is 13. So you have seen, children, left hand side is equals to right hand side. That means my answer is correct. The quantity which I have found is absolutely right. So you understood, children? In the left hand side, either the sign is positive or negative. On the right hand side, when it goes, its sign changes. And so as for right hand side. So I will take one more example of multiplication and division. Suppose I have 100 multiplied by x, that is equal to, suppose, 200. Okay. So now, this 100 is multiplying with x. So when I will take 100 to this side, this will convert into division. So I will write x is equals to 200 divided by 100. I can write it like this, 200 upon 100. So 100 twos are 200. So the value of x is 2. Clear, children? Here when I put 2, so 100 multiplied by 2 is 200. So here the left hand side will become equals to the right hand side. So here it is proven. You understood, children? How we can solve the equations and how we can solve the unknown quantities in these kinds of equations. Now, I will teach you this formula or this LHS-RHS rule, how we can use in LCM and HCM in those relationships. So, let's see. Now, look here, children. You remember that formula, that product of two numbers is equals to the product of LCF and LCM. Suppose you have a question in which two numbers are given, that are 15 and 20. Its LCM is given 16 and you have to find out its HCF. Okay? So now what you will do, as this is left hand side and this is right hand side. Because 60 is multiplying with this number which is unknown, so when I will take this number from right hand side to the left hand side, it will divide over here. I will solve this. 15 twos are 30. So it becomes 300 is equals to HCF multiplied by 60. Now I will take this 60 in the left hand side. So I can write HCF is equals to 300 divided by 60 because multiplication is given over here. So when it will change its position, its sign will also change. So 300 divided by 60. So answer is 5. When I divide 300 by 60, 5 6 are 30. So this has become 5. So you can see answer I got 5, that is HCF is 5. When I put this quantity over here, I will check my answer. So let's check the answer. 15 multiplied by 20 is equals to, HCF is given 5. So I will write here 5 multiplied by 60. 5 6 are 30. 15 2s are 30. So here you can see, children, left hand side is equals to the right hand side. Hence you can use this rule, LHS and RHS rule, is in all the equation wherever you have to find out one unknown quantity. Suppose if one number is missing, it is not given, then you can take this quantity that side when these two quantities are given. Thank you so much, children.